You guys are behind with your payments. What do you, you think just...
Why is it everywhere I go? Is someone getting hustled by someone else?
Do you need to be the hero?
Ah, fuck, this guy's more from North America.
Union?
Oh dear god, they are evil.
Nothing wrong with a union.
Is that a joke about who's on strike recently? Tube drivers now? Always they are. Always they. I choose to go to London as well, the bastard.
The most recent major strike that I'm getting in newspapers are the junior doctors. Let's not turn this into a political thing.
That's the best line ever written. That is the guy whose balls is retracted in Rasputin's body. Assuming he has balls in the Kavina plate, I don't know.
I knew you boys would see reason. Now get out of here.
Too bad. I was looking forward to cracking some heads.
Break shit.
Next time, Candris. I better get this over to Davik. I'll call you if anyone else gets behind on their payments.
You can break some kneecaps, if you know what I mean.
Those Vulkers are dumber than a Coruscant granite slug. They actually think being in that pathetic little gang of
that
makes them important.
I assume so.
Gadon keeps his hidden Bex in line, but Brezhik's getting dreams of grandeur. If Davik's smart, he'll slap that young punk back down.
Permanently.
I'm
Here
someone you don't want to get on the
outside
of.
Mandalorian.
And I'm not one for small talk.
He doesn't give a shit. He's out here to get drunk and get some women with his guns. I'm off. He'll be important later. Mandalorian. Without his armor.
Yeah, without the armor. Yeah, that was a key thing I noticed there.
He's just without the armor, Mandalorian. Green! I've just... Eat sword, fiend! Oh, my lightsaber.
Can you sound any more?
I'll harm you! I hit like a nerd. Three lip wristed throw. Don't make me call my mummy on you.
Mom,
he's been horrible. He called me a poop head. Look at this goatee. I'm clearly a Sith.
Got the proper security papers, you better just turn around.
Look, seriously, how do you see out this helmet? Look at this bit facial hair. I clearly the villain here.
You don't need to see my papers.
No, you didn't have to force it. You can't. You can put that later on, people.
Yes,
later on through plot convenience you become a Jedi. You go to discover you have a connection to the Force, hence the visions you've been having. You go through the speediest Jedi train ever. It's literally a Rocky montage. It's the eye of the Bantha.
You there! Panther's another knight.
No, I can't think of a Star Wars with a tiger or something. First thing we knew was Panther.
Yeah,
I have the Wampa.
This is our elevator. If you use it,
I have the Tauntaun. Didn't quite work.
I don't believe this planet. Even the beggars are trying to shake us down. Five credits. That's what it costs to use our elevator.
Why is everywhere I go beggars are so handy? You're like the lepers in Assassin's Creed, or the minstrels in Assassin's Creed 2, who are even more annoying because they sing at you. Just walk around the street and hello then. We're around that loop right after our ass.
All we ask is a few credits to make our lives easier. Credits, my brother! We have credits. Now we can buy food and
from the
medicine.
Shop that's
Hush,
down here.
The others will hear us. They'll want our credits. We have to hide them.
Go on, you two. Get out of here. I'm sorry about that. Those two beggars give everyone in the village a bad name. We aren't all like that, you know. Most of us are good people.
I'm sure you are,
miss. What accent is that?
It's just too bad the little welcoming committee is here to give people a bad first impression.
That's an accent from the lower hemisphere of...
My name is Shalina.
Planet here.
You're from the upworld, aren't you?
Yes, I'm from the upworld.
I've never seen it.
It's called that because everyone's up there on us in the upworld.
Is it as nice as they say up there?
Sounds slightly Eastern European. It's got a European.
Not to you. Wait, if the Empire is the English, where's Europe into this?
I've never been to
this source. Every bad guy in Star Wars has an English accent because of Imperial accents.
Well, traditionally in Hollywood, Eastern Europeans are usually bad guys as well, remember?
So wonderful. I'm what a Russian Sith Lord, you know? Tells me I should spend more time trying to improve. Just like this straight Sith Lord, but very heavy Russian accent. Something I can never have. Maybe he's right. Like Tim Curry level accent. Having dreams
of a place I've never seen.
So when I was little, Lukil used to tell me stories of what it was like up
there. You'd probably get more information from Gendar, the village leader, or maybe Rukil.
Gendar.
I'll tell you whatever I can.
Is everyone's name in this universe stupid?
I don't know anything about
that. I'm really there, so I was named something stupid.
You just want to meet one day, there's a Jedi or someone called Sean.
No, just called Bob. Jedi Master Grandmaster Bob. From the surface marching through the village, but he came from humble beginnings, Bob did. Gendar might know more about that. He was a woman.
He'll be somewhere in the village. You went slightly Yoda speak there.
Came from humble beginnings.
Yeah, Yoda standing later. Although that one talks fluently English, does not talk in the... So I think Yoda was stupid.
Okay. Well, if you
we can be asked to learn language more, properly.
If you just feel like talking, come back and see me.
Yeah. I'm never going to see you again. And spoiler alert, you're going to die later.
Oh, no.
FYI.
No, really.
I plan it. You've seen Taris in the Old Republic.
Yeah, I know, but I don't want it to die.
I have planned it leveled. We rarely see your time like here in the inner city. Everyone likes me. I'm inherently likable. With my mullet. No offense, but... Yeah, Karth, you failed because you don't have a mullet. Why have you come into this dark and sunless place? Is there something you need of me or my village? Your way you talk is like sinister. It's too calm. It's too calm. Okay, Karth, you're alone. Shunned from the surface for our crimes and banished here to the Undercity. We banded together to form this village that we might survive in this hostile environment. I am Gendar, leader of this village. As my father was and as was his father before him. Many of us have been here for generations. Our ancestors cast down long ago. There is no return to the surface for us or our descendants.
But somehow
we managed to survive amidst the filth and
Roman bands of death. I don't think they can use it.
What to do, read who you are? It's the elevator. Life down here can be difficult. It can break the spirit. Many in the village have become bitter and hopeless, especially those newly cast down. But life goes on, and we must try to make the best of what we have. You're too calm for this situation. We will find a better either you're high on drugs, or there's something sinister going on here. I'm starting to sound like Rukil.
Who the hell is Rukil?
Rukil's a story master, and if we talk to him, this video will be 2 hours long. their diseased jaws can infect those they attack. Still annoying in the Old Republic. Abominations. We know of no cure for the disease. Although they get this only bigger in the Old Republic. We must banish any who might not quite big. And some of them can use the Force, but that's really gets weird. Ask your questions, Upworlder. I will answer to the best of my knowledge. Please, just call me Up. I know little beyond the borders of the Undercity.
Yes, I have seen this Twi'lek many times, though I've never spoken to her. Don't, she's really irritating. She often passed through our village on their way to explore the sewers.
Yeah, because don't you go to explore the sewers when you're bored? The sewers from the Undercity.
One to the north. Yeah, no, of course I do.
It's the first place, you know. But the sludge is good for the skin. If you dare to travel those how Twi'leks have their complexion. Well, female Twi'leks have their complexion. Unless you wish to become a meal for the Rakghuls and the other foul creatures. Oh, there's more than just a Rakghul. Great, this is going to sound like fun, this is. If you ask me to skin 5 rabbits, I am leaving. Our village what has did that woman bounce off car? Surface recently. Armored troops, swoop gang members, mercenaries. They come to search our sunless world. They're even searching the sewers. I keep mentioning these sewers. These people keep walking into my shops. Should you have need of anything else, come speak to me. I represent the entire village, and I will do my best to help you however I can. Okay, you're going to join something called the Sith Empire. What? I'm trying to change sides. Blame one with a brain, we're like, it's Jedi, but far from the good guys.
You ain't from the village. You're from the Upworld, ain't you? Yes.
This guy sounds rational. Watch yourself.
There's something no, it's aren't you, not ain't you.
Ain't you? As far as I can
throw him. My name's Tygir. I run a little salvage shop here. You want to buy something from my store? I got some good deals.
On junk. This is for a forward junk as a purpose.
Isn't the best stuff, not it ain't, it isn't.
Imagine you going to some like poor beggar and just correcting their grammar. And like, you buff, get an education for God's sake. And pick yourself up and don't shuffle. What the hell's wrong with you? That's the beggars these days, just don't have any guts. Muttering, anyway. After I got these ramps, this game lacks a jump button.
Hurry, Hindar! Hurry!
Oh, Hindar. Hindar and Gendar, they must be related.
He's doomed. I told him he was a fool to leave the village.
He will make it. Run, Hindar, run!
I have that voice in something, I'm not sure why.
Open the gate!
Flee!
Quickly! There isn't much time! I can't. The Rakkuls are too close.
The mutants will kill him if you don't open the gate.
And if I open the gate, they'll kill us all.
No, you can't.
So either way, they win.
Is it fair?
Please, or one of
make
them.
Him open the gate. Hindar will die if he doesn't.
I can't open the gate. Not while the Rakkuls are so near.
It's time we've had this conversation. You can open the gate, let him in, and close it again.
You'd risk your life for a stranger? You're brave, Upworlder. I'll open the gate for
brave,
you, but you've got to
be quick.
They're
often confused.
In a few seconds, I must close and lock it again.
See, they're running. Run. This guy's stupid. He's got a death wish. All right, where did you rackle them? I see nothing. Ah, they're right there. All right, Bob, you and me. Let's do this. Good job in prison evil tradition. I'm immune to their virus. All right, Carl, you gonna help? Oh God, I've gone green. When you fight an evil mutant that can infect you on bites, you fight it hand to hand.
Naturally.
Like a Fallout, let's see, I'm gonna punch a death claw. Good luck with that. Here's a gun. Bite me, level up screen. Leveling up. Don't rush your car, this is an important business. Ooh, I'm gray neutrality.
One would assume so.
Well, you start in the middle and you go light or dark.
Yeah.
Because Star Wars is anything but a binary morality.
I can't thank you enough for saving
Carl, out of the way. Carl, move.
If
thank
I
you.
Had anything but these rags on my back, it would be yours.
I'll be taking those rags.
I still have you, Hindar.
Strip for me.
That's all I need.
Slowly.
Let's go back to the village.
Ooh, lightside points. But that's how that works. Gain points on each side. That balances out in the end. That's how that works. Ooh,
please,
all this
you
open.
Have to help me. Nobody else is gonna help me. Even the Bex won't help me. But I can't just leave him there. He's my friend. You'll help me, won't you?
I sense I'm gonna regret saying yes to this.
Zalvar, he's in trouble. Big trouble. We have to help him. If we don't, they'll sell him into slavery.
Oh, the other Star Wars thing. Slavery.
Ah, of course.
Me and Zalvar,
which never really gets addressed a lot of the time, does it? It's just something that's there.
Mentioning. Yeah, well, no, like kids film.
We do it all the time.
I guess with a Wookiee at your side,
also
you
blood.
Figure you can handle the odd rat ghoul attack.
And then they have lightsabers that cauterize wounds conveniently.
They were waiting for us. Gamorrean slave hunters.
And for a series that has a fetish for dismembering people.
He threw himself at him and then roared for me to run. I took off. I figured Zalbar
literally,
would
I have jet
me.
Boots.
But there were
Star Wars
so
needs jet boots.
I couldn't get away. They're going to sell him to a slaver. I just know it.
Oh, please, he's a Wookiee. Like they count.
Like them sure, count. Those Gamorreans like to hang out in the sewers. The stink
because they're
home,
pigs.
I guess. That's probably
see?
They took Big Z.
I'm bad. Like I'm racist. Just because you have heads and tool things doesn't mean you can be racist.
As soon as we get Big Z
also
back,
you're blue.
I'll show you a way into that Volker base. Now come on. We have to find Zalba before they sell him to slavers. Or worse.
Do you know where
or
he's
worse.
Being
what?
Kept?
Make him into a shag carpet.
I bet that's where we'll find Zalbar.
That's
where I'll show you the secret entrance into the Volker compound.
Because every base is a secret entrance.
Yes.
Useful if we want to break in. She's a scoundrel, is she? No, she's an irritation. Yeah. Oh, she brought her own gun. Thank God. Fucking freeloaders. I encourage you to. You have multiple weapon sets and change on the fly. You have a range within the melee weapon. Inventory menu. This is basically a numbers game. He'd argue every game's a numbers game when it comes down to it. Yeah, my knife.
You call that a knife?
I knew that.
This is a knife.
Put that lightsaber. Certainly not a knife. Oh, I got a med kit I find in rubble. They're not going to be contaminated whatsoever. Oh, hey, Candace, why are you down here? With your massive gun.
I call her Sheila.
When Mandalorian's an Australian. Of course, Sheila. In fact, Michael Crozier too, there's some very iffy Mandalorian accents all over the place.
Settle down, kid. We've already lost enough.
Hang on, doesn't he look exactly like the guy that we said before?
It's the same guy.
No, no, not him.
Oh,
the other one.
Yeah, there are limited outfits.
I'd say you're down here for the same reason we are. To salvage some
party.
Of those downed
party,
Republic space pods. Let me give you some advice. Forget about it. Do yourself a favor and just head back from where you came.
Okie dokie.
I'm kind of stuck on this ship.
That's Candoris Ordo. He's the most famous Mandalorian mercenary in this sector of the galaxy. This isn't a good place to stand around chatting. The Undercity is crawling.
Here's my business card. Count Ordo, ruthless mercenary. Monsters. Call this number.
I heard something. Over there.
And book an appointment with his secretary, like Doreen.
Looks like we've got company. Get those blasters ready, boys.
Go, get him! I'm not gonna help. Get him! Oh, hell. Yeah!
Damn. I told Dovick this,
this guy is kind of
a bad idea.
Wait,
his men
aren't move.
Trained for this.
You're in the way of a conversation. Screw you, stand to keep you having a conversation.
Okay, boys.
We're also, we're wearing the same outfit. That's just awkward.
Else. I can't carry all this salvage back by myself. You'd be smart to get out of here as well.
All of the
even
salvage
you can
I
handle
have.
The
just look at it, it's everywhere.
I doubt there's anything worth finding anymore. Davik sent me down here with this motley crew to scavenge whatever we could from the Republic
I
escape pods that
crew.
Crashed during the recent
all
battle
crew should
overhead.
Be motley.
But the lower city motley. Gangs got here first. Anything worthwhile
well,
in those Republic pods is
yeah,
probably
that's
in their
kind.
Hands by
then
now.
You get dramatic tension, that's great for
like
the plot.
That. What are you, an off-worlder? Everyone knows.
Well, we having a conversation in the middle
of
a sewer.
You know, the interstellar crime syndicate. Smuggling, gambling, extortion. Davik controls it all here on Taris. That's why I'm working for him. But lately, the lower city gangs have been giving my boss some trouble.
Yes, the exchange. Mysterious cabal of criminals.
Mm. Come on, boys, let's move out.
Just jetpack off. Okay, be very sneaky. Uh-oh, mine.
Yeah?
Exactly how are you defusing that? So you're like, what, telepathically? It's a mile away.
What are you doing?
Yes, you're saving the mine. Just to prove that you can. You need to find these sewers. Yes, go! Why didn't I rack up credits on it? It's like, go to the shop occasionally and buy some sweet threads that it then eats. Because it's the mindless monster who just devours anything. Ooh, sewerage.
No, I was just thinking of the robot chicken sketch with the, oh, what was it?
Which robot? I assume it's a Star Wars robot chicken sketch.
The Wampa.
The one at the petrol station, the one
yeah, one at the petrol station, which is the saddest yeah. sketch in the world. That thing just breaks your heart watching that sketch.
And then you remember Luke and the Emperor's rat battle, or Yo Mama battle.
Yeah.
And then you say everything's okay with the galaxy again. Or Darth Vader's when his wizard. I'm bringing it back!
Yes. That was pretty wizard, wasn't it, son?
What? I'm bringing it back! I love it when he thinks of himself, he's just watching and says, wait, I do?
The best one he goes, you gonna kiss me? My father gonna kiss the Emperor? Because the moment he leans in, it was romantic. Dear Emperor. Oh my god, this really hurts. If the Emperor asked me to turn to the dark side, I might say yes.
No.
Did you?
No, I can feel it.
That is the quickest mutation I've ever fucking seen. The doctor doesn't regenerate that quickly.
What the hell?
Miracle. That's how quickly it happens. It just happens.
Are you safe?
Yeah, I'm at the character of evil. I get bitten as many times as I want, but I'm fine. There's one of the pods that crashed.
I find it amazing the clothes just deteriorated in the same instance as
it's
well.
It's like Hulk. It just... Meanwhile, 20 hours later in the sewers... Ah! Gamorreans! Oh god, there's not those lot of them.
It's Gamorreans, isn't it? Not just nothing more.
Pick people with axes!
Oh yeah, that's racist.
They are pick people... with... What do you want me to say? Like inflicts dancers. Well, female ones. I've never seen a male pick down, so that I think would be terrifying.
They'll exist.
Ready.
Oh my god. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Cast shoot, man! Oh, thank god, cast on the ball. Alright, they'll be fine. They'll wake up in a bit. See, they're fine.
Yeah?
Yes?
Do I want to know what that water pouring down is? Or is it better just not to ask? Ah, oh, med kit, I'm fine now.
What?
If anyone asks Karth, you died and I saved your ass.
Sure.
Gotta keep the illusion going. See, he agrees, sure. Just pop myself full of drugs. Ooh, a cardio regulator.
Look at this.
That's basically a heart monitor.
Yeah.
If I have a heart attack, I will know.
Old style manual lock. I reckon it'll be a generation into our future when kids start actually saying that.
Have to use a hairpin to unlock it. How fucking primitive. Now it's just hack. Although if you are going to have any close computers, it'll be a lot easier to break in. You can just hack it.
I'm glad to see you too, Big Z. You didn't think I'd forget about you.
Let's hug it out.
Mission in Dalbar, together forever.
Intergalactic smugglers. We should get a TV deal from this.
These are my new friends, Big Z. Without them, I could never have got you out.
Standing heroically next to the sewage pipe. Their pose, defiant at the end. We stand against the Sith. And then run away like a coward.
So we missed you speaking.
Yeah, I'm questioning if do you actually answer, because Wookiees can understand. Yeah. Basics, they understand. Do you roar at him? Everyone gives you a look of like, what are you doing? An image now of me as speaking Wookiee.
You sure about that, Pixie? Think about it carefully. You better be sure about this.
Is that your final answer? Well, this will get everything later on and get the cash out of me. I'm looking forward. Epic.
Because it can't, it's not succinct, is it?
It's very... epic, like family politics, betrayal, all done in Wookiee roars. Yeah, it would be dramatic if it wasn't. That was a Chewie. That was a Wookiee dying.
Is he swearing a Wookiee life debt to you? Wow.
As opposed to those cheapo Gungan life debts.
Do you realize what it means?
No one likes those guys.
I at least like the Gungans, I just don't like that particular battle. One.
They make great Kamari.
It means to stay by yourself for the rest of your life. Wherever you go, whatever you do, Zalbar will be with you.
Can I call you a walking carpet? I get those references in there somehow. Never trust a planet with three Y's in its name.
Laugh it up, Buzzball.
That was Han Solo having that.
It's not gonna happen again.
Yeah, can we just get this show on the road? I got things to do.
So, I guess I still owe you one secret.
I've got a Sith Empire to defeat, a Jedi to rescue,
don't worry.
Many women to bed in my epic galactic conquest of the galaxy.
Many women to bed?
Hell yeah, man, we're doing this. I am epic hero. That's gonna be in my dreams. I'm just gonna go and to quote someone from Kodor 2, I'm just gonna go scratch my equipment. There was a masturbation joke. There was a masturbation joke in Kodor 2.
There used to be a Rancor monster that made its nest in that part of the sewer.
I'm gonna go polish my. I'm trying to think of the actual Star Wars you can get in front of.
That thing is huge.
Well, it's like the Robot Chicken sketch of the Toshi converters. They're actually strippers.
Yeah.
So I'm sure we'll figure something.
The power converter is at Tosh's station here, actually.
Unless you want to change your mind.
I'm sorry, I blanked the entire conversation. What were you doing? I was too busy living my epic fantasy of intergalactic scoundrel.
Like I said, somewhere to the southeast. Just look for the force shield.
Oh, that's
and we'll
nice
know
and
we're
specific.
There.
You now have a Wookiee in your party. Which means you now win every fight.
Yay.
Because as we all know, you let the Wookiee win.
Let the Wookiee win.
That's almost there for Chewie. Have a sword. I don't think Wookiees can wear armor.
Wouldn't that be weird if they could?
That's not a real chicken sketch. Chewie's family, they're all clothed. He goes, "You've been naked all these years." He goes, "Oh, I love you," and goes to hug him. Oh well, more investigating these sewers. When did my life go so wrong? I was a popular soldier of the military. You know, climbing the ranks, protecting the Jedi and important Jedi business. Where did my life go down a shithole?
What?
The entire time keeps freezing around here.
I should have gone to college.
Space college.
Finished
the degree in Republic politics.
Could have been somewhere.
I could have been a senator.
Like my brother.
No.
You won't be able to.
Mom always liked him best, didn't she? Well, I'm not like him, Mom.
One day I'll show her.
I've got them. I picked them off the pocket of Black Vulgar, who had a
I'll make money in this galaxy and own my own starship. Then I'll go fly to a flyby in her house. Then we'll see who's laughing. Then, Mom. Epic hero to real insecure.
What?
Oh, the force field's gone. Woo! Force field! Ah, more sewers. These are the higher class upper sewers.
Ooh,
yeah?
Fancy.
You can tell, it's only full of less shit. More urine, but less shit. We now have a problem, because there appears to be a Rancor guard in the entrance.
Ah!
So we can either fight it, or get clever and use mission stealth generator, because she's now invisible and stuck on something, which is why she's not moving. There we are, right. Okay, now we sneak.
Be very, very quiet.
Quiet. There's a Rancor ray over there. Why am I whistling? I hear that. Then we put in this pile a frag grenade and some of these mysterious chemicals we picked up from that guy's body over there. Then we'll see what happens. Then we fade to black. Uh-oh, Rancor.
Snort.
The fluid grenade on his stomach. I feel there should be more blood than that. Woo!
I think that grenade was surprisingly weak. Those things are pretty damn sturdy.
Yeah! Don't mess with me. I took a Rancor down. If anyone asks, I beat it hand to hand with my bare fists. So we've all got our story straight. I'm looking at you, Karth. I know you're not here anymore. Still looking at you. Uh-oh. Damn it, these guys are tactical geniuses. They put guards on the rear entrance. Diabolical. Yeah, energy shields don't do well against melee weapons. Just FYI. You know, criminal gangs, they're kind of easy to kick their asses. Stupid galaxy.
Yeah?
Yes?
Now we found their secret base. Now we should go searching around their secret base for the prototype engine. That's what we came here for back last week.
That's what it was.
Last week we came for that. It's like I've been down here for months. Okay, right. Stealth mission, people. Stealth mission. Well, that went out the window, but it was destroyed right there. Well, that went out the window. Eat grenade! Mission, you have a gun, you don't need to get that close to him. Initial aim is that bad. soon we'll have our droid companion, and soon this game becomes very, very funny.
Still a long way off, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
So when you say soon?
Sooner than...
Sooner than it was earlier.
Yes. Sooner than it was a minute ago. A droid made a funny noise when I get hit. When your droid dies, they need to explode in sparks everywhere. That way you know your droid was built by the droid company. I don't know any droid companies in. Actually make the droids.
Fair Federation.
They made battle droids. But this is 4,000 years before all that.
The trade community.
The trade guy. And it's just one guy.
He's just going like,
hello! You Gunray was that fucking old.
What?
Man, their droids suck more than... At least these ones are quiet and don't talk.
Yes.
You know, for some reason, when I imagine the trade guy, I'm imagining Birdman from Red Dwarf.
Yes.
Just going, do you remember which one I'm talking about?
Yeah, it's from Series 8. The one that's a bird that turns into a dinosaur.
Yeah, Pete. His name is Pete. That's how I imagine he
Birdman, I thought of Mike Keaton.
No, not that one. That is something I want to see, though.
It's a good film.
Have you seen it?
Yes.
It's rare for you to see films.
It's a good film. Weirdly kind of meta, because Michael Keaton was Batman.
Yeah, the whole thing is a little bit meta,
weirdly. Burn.
Sure.
Okay, just outfitting everyone. Yeah, this can't enjoy here. Ooh, a computer. You can hack everything.
Yes?
Yeah?
Shh! Wookie. Stealth mission. Why are you taking a Wookiee on the stealth mission when it's a 6 foot tall rug?
He's 6 foot one and he's tons of fun and he dresses to a T.
Six foot one, eh? And he's full of fun as well. I'm like, we need some more computer spikes, sir.
He dresses to a T.
Huh?
I've been watching Rapper's Delight recently.
Simple. Good for you.
Sure.
Holy shit. Wow, the balls from this guy! Three armed people run into your office, you just grab a sword and run at them.
Yeah. Kill him.
Sounds like Alexander Armstrong, half the Emperor.
Good. Your anger. Makes you powerful, gives you focus.
Gives you. Hold on, my phone's ringing. Yes.
Hello.
My pizza's here.
No, I do not have. I did not apply for any PPI.
My lord, your pizza's here. Did they bring any dip? No, my lord. Fire at will, commander. Oh dear. Yeah. Took gang from me. So what the term the Twi'lek skin coloration? Racial thing? I'm curious. But most species that have right bits because they vary dramatically in color.
You would assume it has to be genetic in some way, but you assume it's like hair color type thing, maybe.
Like a certain region of Rydoff they come from, they have different coloration. There's probably a book somewhere explains it. This book explains everything.
Yeah.
Whatever, just wait, let's get there. I think another recent Star Wars has multiple skin colors, like dramatically different skin colors. Like right, for you, actually. For humans. If you count them as humans in the Star Wars galaxy.
They're never called humans, are they?
Not, they're not, technically. Humans come from planet Earth.
Yeah. But are they given any kind of name? Or
I know the human population of Naboo are called the Naboo.
Yeah.
So I assume they just, you know, that's, you know, the human population of Tatooine is called scumbags. To their most population of Tatooine is called scumbags. Scumbags and Hutts, who are bigger scumbags. And that guy who owned Anakin who flew somehow on wings that did not flap nearly fast enough.
Watto.
Conti-chani. Are you still talking?
Apparently so.
Oh, he's saying, yeah. I'll take them down, don't worry. I'll kick his ass. I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy.
Watto is a Toydarian, isn't he?
Is racist stereotypes what he is.
He's like, a racist stereotype.
Just like most people in Star Wars.
Yes, he is, but he's not from Tatooine because his race are from a marsh planet.
Imagine if the humans are from Tatooine. The native population of Tatooine is technically the same people. Or is it not?
Jawas?
The Jawas don't. You see Jawas not a planet, so I don't think they're native to Tatooine. Some people you only really see in Tatooine. Tusken Raiders. Uh-oh. Guys, I didn't mean to come in here. I'm just different people. Who ordered the calamari? I mean actual calamari, not... Amran Akbar calamari. I was expecting it's
a chance. No, they are native to Tatooine. Yeah, I just looked them up.
Yeah. Oh, I think Tatooine, they're
playing Jawas. I love Jawas.
They're opening Jawas around. Sure. And some people. You thought the Wookiee roar was 9 meters tall. Sure. These blast bolts are too accurate for sand people. Only Imperial stormtroopers are that accurate. Huh? Yes, stormtroopers are accurate. And
yeah.
Too fair. That's not unfair to stormtroopers because moops in most things can't aim straight.
Yes, very true.
It's just most funny with the stormtroopers.
They'll be back. An ingrained number.
This guy is healthy. This guy's clearly got paid the big bucks. He has a health kit on him.
He's a lieutenant.
Get him, Zalma! I'll be over here. I'll be over here to let the mission, even though I'll probably get arrested by the space police for that.
The space police.
Because there is a space police in Star Wars. The space police. And their body cop. One's a human, the other's a Jawa. Body cops. Drama of the
film. Oh, I want to see that.
He's a Jawa cop who doesn't play by the rules.
By the rules.
I want a badass Jawa smoking
still,
cigar.
Still sounds all this. He still speaks like a Jawa as well. He's got.
Like got a bandolier, massive gun, smokes a cigar.
No. I'd want him to be voiced by Danny Glover.
Arnold Schwarzenegger. Arnold Schwarzenegger trying to do a Jawa
Arnie's
voice.
Partner. And Danny Glover is the voice of the Jawa.
Yeah. Body cop movie of the century. Not since De Niro and Pacino and Heath. Coming this summer to you, to a hollow vid near you. Hey, we found the pool! Awesome! I'm calling pool party! Although, imagine a Wookiee wet is a very sorry sight.
Yeah, I can imagine this time.
Wookiees don't swim. I just ordered that droid to commit suicide. The droid rights activists, because they must be somewhere. Droids don't really have rights. Don't you keep your select cargo in the pool behind gas mines? Where else would you put it, frankly?
Huh? Yes?
This pool is dank as shit as well, man.
So you can speak?
Yeah, but it's like the main character in Skyrim. You technically do speak, you're just not voiced. The difference between a silent protagonist and a not voice protagonist. You technically talk, you just don't hear it.
Well, like compared with, like, Chell.
Yeah. She's a silent protagonist, she doesn't actually talk. The main character in Skyrim does have dialogue, it's just not voice, it's just all done text. Often means you can actually do actual conversation branches, you don't have to pay a voice actor to play, say, 40 variations of one thing. And you can compare like Shell and Gordon Freeman, who are just silent protagonists who never utter a word. Although Chell has a reason for why she doesn't talk.
She's deaf, isn't she?
No, she doesn't want to give Gladys the satisfaction of getting her reaction out of her.
Is that the official reason?
That is the official reason she doesn't talk. She does not want to give the satisfaction, which doesn't explain why she doesn't talk to Wheatley, but there's many other
Please
reasons
don't
to Wheatley.
Me. I just
it's like talking to a black
here, that's all.
Oh,
I'm not
brick
like
wall.
Others. I'm not even a black Vulker. Please don't kill me. My name is Ada.
No.
My
you
father
look like a gang.
Davik some money, but he couldn't pay. Davik killed my father and sold me into slavery here at the Vulker compound to pay off the debt.
Why is ever I go to slavery? It's following me around like a...
I still don't know how much help I can be, but But I sure hope you get rid of all the Vulkers.
First question first. Where's the bathroom? Been holding this in for days, man. I haven't had one bathroom on this planet.
I guess it might be in the garage on the lower level. That's where all the Vulkers go to work on their swoop bikes. But I've never been down there. The elevator is protected by a security system. Only the Vulkers are allowed to go down there. Is she that Republic soldier? I heard one of the Vulkar mention her, but she's not here. He said Brezhik didn't trust his men around her.
God.
I guess she's too important to be a slave.
Yeah, I know, but...
Getting pawed and groped and kicked and spit on like me. Brezhik must have taken her somewhere safe.
That's just me whenever I talk to any woman. The punching and the kicking, not the groping.
Now that killed the guards who were supposed to...
Well, how you talk to them, or
how they talk to me?
Right.
It's, hey!
I'm free to go?
I only wanted to know the bloody time was.
Mom!
I can never repay you! Thank you! Thank you! I have to get out of here before any of the Vulkars see me.
Now, they're mostly dead, so don't worry. She's got life of poverty ahead of her. Anyway. freeing people from slavery gives you a warm, fuzzy feeling. Well, it might just be the drugs kicking in. Oh, gas mine! Man, force reflexes. That Wookiee don't give a shit about that gas mine. These gang members seem pretty keen to gas their own gang members.
Very.
It's getting worrying now. I know bad guys in Star Wars kill mooks daily. It's a thing.
Still.
It's a thing. I need a pass card. Oh, looting some more bodies. That's a really dank gang base. I was expecting like a disco. You know, loud pumping music. There's loud pumping music exists in the Star Wars universe. Because every cantina band plays one song and one song only. Ooh, pass card. Woo! Ooh, two in case one fails. Alright, onwards we go. Yes, there is a button that is solely to flourish a weapon. Seriously, there are no toilets on this entire planet. What do you do when you gotta go? Just go in the streets? What are these savages? I'm starting to see this point here. Heh, stupid turrets. To the garage! Can we just nick a swoop bike and just ride out of it?
That's not a bad shout.
Just whoop in and put the stereo on to smooth hits of the galaxy. I can count as two people at once. This guy is a skilled swordsman. That guy wasn't, he died in 2 hits. Okay, is it in here now? Someone's office just broke into. Sweet, let's loot their stuff. I'm the good guy in this operation. Hey, they're criminals. That means they have no right to personal property. Although they are aliens, and this could be considered racism if someone catches me doing this. After all, I am a white guy. But I don't know where white guys stand in the Star Wars galaxy.
Well, we know that the Empire is typically...
The Empire doesn't give a shit about human race, it doesn't give a shit about Indian race.
Yeah, that's my point.
It's people, someone tried to claim the Empire's racist, they went, yeah, against aliens, not against black people.
Well, that's the thing, is once you introduce a new concept of what it means to be different, you're able to unite that. You're able to unite the race. Species, rather.
So someone named a black Imperial officer, and there are only 2 black people in the entire Star Wars, 3 now. Black people in the entire Star Wars galaxy.
Lando Calrissian.
Lando Calrissian, Finn, and Mace Windu.
Oh yeah, Mace Windu. I can't remember the other one.
3 black people in the entire galaxy.
And it's one, if you notice, for each of the trilogies.
Yes. And only one of those is the smoothest
character
ever.
We gotta do something about your breath. I didn't
Lando Calrissian. I am the administrator of the city. Hard to believe. Also, I'm Billy D. Now, inherently smooth, so smooth. Since we rescued you from those Gamorrean
slavers. What'd they feed you, buddy?
I bit one of their arms. Let me grab that, because they haven't washed them at all.
Oh, Zalbar, that's terrible. I know how grouchy you get if you don't get your 8 square meals a day. I'm amazed you didn't pass out from hunger.
8 square meals?
8 times the mother chew is pissed off throughout the entire trilogy. He wasn't getting his food. God damn it, huh? Let the Wookiee eat. Well, they are bigger, I suppose. They might eat more when they're human.
No wonder your breath is so bad, Big Z. Gamorreans smell like bantha poodoo. We'll have to pick you up a toothbrush to clean that stench out of your chest.
See, I'm saying that if you're trying to say poo-poo or poodoo is like the technical term for it. Like, some poo has technical terms for it, so I'm like, rather than just being shit.
That's the weirdest line I've ever seen.
What?
Wookiees do not brush their teeth, relax. Mission. It just isn't done. Why would they do it?
I always didn't say Wookiees do not brush their teeth. It is a great dishonor. That smell, okay?
Stay away from anything that's smart enough to
It's a great dishonor to oneself. Wookiees don't brush. They floss. With the gizzards of their prey. I'm glad we had the conversation. That was vital for the plot.
Yes, I'm glad we did as well.
We need to know that he eats 8 square meals a day and doesn't brush his teeth.
Or comb.
You need a hell of a comb to get through a Wookiee's hair.
That's actually not... Yeah, that's a good point.
Right, now we get the I am the middle of this piece.
Breshik stole that engine from Gadget.
So if a green twig and a yellow twig have a baby, what color will it be? Still on this. Just hear it.
Hang on, we've seen. No, I'm not going to say the line.
What?
Did we see him earlier?
No, he's a different guy. If you mean the guy we let free, no, it's a different guy.
Right. He looks exactly the same.
Yeah, they do.
And suddenly, I just sound like a racist.
Yeah. Oh, damn, Twi'leks, they all look the same.
Same to me.
Taking our jobs, our women. God damn it, we should build a wall around the entire planet.
I will build the greatest wall there's ever been. Who's gonna pay for it? The Twi'leks.
I'm gonna hear a wall. I think of the Robin Williams sketch about Arnold as governor.
Yeah, he says, I will build a wall.
I will build a wall.
Okay, the Chinese going, that
will not
work.
It will go around. It will go under your wall.
That was immediately what I thought when he had a head about the wall as well. The Robin Williams sketch. It's a brilliant one.
Oh, the weather is
that was weapons of mass destruction, wasn't it?
Yes,
it was weapons of self-destruction.
Himself, you know, when he's like, yeah, just give me the damn engine, no one needs to get hurt. Is that a gong droid behind you or a Lurbin?
Lurbin, I think. There's no legs to it, so.
It might be him. That's all Gong Droid is, lipping with legs. Someone
I
got
love
ripped
Gong
the drunk
Droid.
One day. Next playable class in Old Republic, Gong Droid.
Yeah!
Or Companion. Why is there isn't
a Companion would be awesome.
You get a jar while with Rocket Launcher.
I love it when you go to Hoth with him.
You get yeah, him,
yeah.
He's got the fur line Jawa.
He's got the fur line.
That is adorable. Oh, man, adorable. That's high five, man. I mean, the best companion, though. They're all fun. I like young Ken Val, the Dashar assassin, the Sith Inquisitor. He just hates everyone and just wants to kill everyone. And it goes well with my Sith Inquisitor, he wants to kill everyone as well.
What?
He's quite a tactical thing. Okay, the bodyguards first. I'll turn my back on him. Eat my ass. What? This guy's tactics to do. And by tactics, I mean spam. Attack on him. Throw grenades. I'm like 90 circle sweeping. So is she his lover or his bodyguard? We need details, Missy. I want to know who I'm killing. Oh, wait, it's all out. Pulled right out of his ass. Okay, so he can deflect against two guys with the sword and someone with a gun. This guy should be a Jedi. Maybe he is a Jedi. He's gone rogue. Like, Lord, this is okay. It's like, if they use a little bin, there's like three of them in a row there. How much litter do they have? Great death screen there. to pay the actor the big bucks to get those desk screens. What to pick? I don't know why it gets more interesting when you get your force powers. Some of them get inventive. Right, loot the bodies for anything useful. Don't give me that look about being immoral and wrong. They're criminals. They're already scum. Inventory sorting.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, now me and Vet run the same thing. That's awkward. Someone needs to change now. Vet. I called the Vet. Mission. Same voice actress. Practically the same character.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, we found our MacGuffin. What do we do with that? Just put it in my pocket. I think it was the size of my arm. You don't want to see me walk all the way back.
No, I don't.
Like, at all. So we're back at the base! Man, this place is...
To be fair, I've got multiple issues with this video being this long anyway, but nevertheless. Swoop engine
accelerator with you? First one, my ass hurts.
I was beginning to... Ah, I forgot it's filled, Lamar. The race
is tomorrow. He's remembered, the guy who's quote-unquote blind. Into the swoop engine
of our bike. It's Green Lantern.
Even though he said he knew what I look like.
Yeah, he said, I'm the guy. I know what one of those looks
like. Yeah, my visor now. I can now see in 3D. That was worked. Don't
worry. I'm a man of it's a rose-tinted visor. I promised you to ride in
the swoop race under the Hidden Beck banner. The original trilogy. I'm still going to let you do that. And I'm even going to go one better. I'm going to let you So yes, you're going to trust your entire gang to someone who, for your concerns, never ridden a swoop bike before. This plan can end well for you.
You can't be serious. We need one of our best riders on that bike.
Color skin is hers, white or purple. What do you go by, the face or the color of the... What should you call it, the film, what they're called?
Leku. Yes. I have to be honest with you. Because I had to ask you what they were called, and you
stopped me. I call them head tentacles. There's a good chance it could explode during... So that's the reason I'm racing. It could blow up. Great, you're filling me with confidence. You're filling me with confidence. I'm glad I'm here, frankly.
I'm here in the room. I'm standing right here.
Try to get me killed by monsters, a Rancor, an entire criminal gang, and they'll say, oh, by the way, it might explode. Starting to hate everyone on this stupid planet. You don't get to be leader of... Your floor decoration is tacky. You can stay here tonight. Yes. The mechanics need time to install the accelerator. On what, the floor? So you won't be able to practice your riding. But I've got good instincts. Oh great, no practice as well. You have a racer about you. This plan has so many ways to go wrong. It's not even funny. You are the worst criminal ever. Did I sleep standing up?
Well, I'm finding it funny if you're not.
You failed. Oh, bite me, Greedo. I'm gonna do this race with the sword in my hand.
I've only got one hand, I don't know what I'm doing, I've never done it before, oh god.
Hey look, a bigger button, what that does.
What's his voice telling me? Use the force?
Shut up Ben, not now. This isn't a trench run. There isn't a trench run. I've got another stupid alien talking to me. Bite me! I've had a wrong night.
Now don't get tetchy.
You seen their food? That's barely fit for human consumption.
It's not designed for humans.
Yeah, you weren't meant to eat that bit. That wasn't food. Oh! Well, the science enrichment language. And I was tired. And in a rush because I've got up late. My alarm didn't go off. And by alarm, I mean cough.
I've always wondered how that species talks.
What, the Etorians?
Yeah.
The force. They can't feel the force. But their mouth's just not where you expect it to be. Mm-hmm. Only human arrogance would assume.
No, I understand that bit. The whole thing of they might not actually have that, but it's just...
I'd think so. They'd have some way, because obviously, how they, and it's, I'm just wondering where they do.
Telepathic.
Mm. Possibly.
They have field force.
Is the force? Does the force allow telepathy?
Do they can read minds?
Yeah, but
the theory is they can communicate with each other telepathically.
Mm, all right.
The force is basically does whatever the writer wants it to do.
Yes, I understand. It's,
that's how the Star Wars universe works.
But the force is a MacGuffin in every sense. So.
It's how this plot point went. The force, it's magic. We don't have to explain it. An intro code or two, which kind of deconstructs that entire idea.
It gets very specific, doesn't it?
Well, it's just kind of the idea of... Well, you know, it's whole concept of a game and how you're able to basically manipulate your companions, and how you level up is explained in universe as a reason in the story of what that is. And by the way, we found Bastila. He's right here.
That's great.
Well, she's kind of still a prisoner and a slave. You need me to win the race to win her. Then she'll do what I say. she's gonna clean all the cunts on the pants.
I've just noticed the outfit she's wearing.
Don't worry, that's nothing but... she will clean all.
Considering Leia's slave outfit, that's...
apparently you're like bastard to wear. So imagine that's metal and that's gonna chafe in places you don't want it in. You get a slave girl for Encryption 2. You can dance for a hut if you want to, Encryption 2. The most badly animated dance ever. And then he falls asleep in your dance. Bastard. Why am I inside
you're, my just, you're just not his type.
I'm not a Macazite. Dyke slug.
Well, to be fair, huts don't have them because they're attracted to them. They have them because they're a symbol of power, don't they?
Probably. I own all of these dancers. What about the guy? He's not a dancer. He's a choreographer. He's just really camp. All choreographers are really camp. And then...
he was a mistake.
You call camp people a mistake? You bastard.
No, I'm saying buying him.
Yeah. Here we have swoop racing. Let's rock this.
Oh god. I've seen your driving in games.
It's
will
a straight line. You move left and right and gear up.
Seriously.
It's time. You have a time to beat. You have to hit the boost pads and change gear at the right moment and avoid the obstacles that will slow you down. In Kotor 2, you can jump over things, which makes it even more terrifying. When I mentioned Kotor 2 is a much better game. Even though it's massively incomplete, it still might be better than most things. Oh god. Oh god, it's getting very fast. Ah! I can't remember what time it was meant to be. He did say at the beginning what time it meant to be.
We're going to see. Have to do this a few times, aren't we?
Twice, because you beat time first and some bastard beats your time again. Dick one. Ooh, what do I get? I get praise. Well, I can't spend that on women and booze.
Again, spend it on women.
You know, buy a couple of dancers at the cantina.
Buy a couple of dancers.
You don't understand how these cantinas work, do you? On some very seedy planets. Because the term female autonomy did not exist. A couple of dancers, a couple of drinks, a bit of pizzak. It's a good life. And this asshole comes along and beats your time again, dickhead. Orange
literally
outfit. And bite him, kick him off nuts for the second pass. And then bite his face off.
You need to beat your time.
Yeah, then you beat his time, you beat your time straight afterwards, dickhead. So you have to go again and beat his new time. Alright then, he made it personal now. I'm the best swoop racer. Hello, ladies. Well, lady, I'm not sure about the other one. It might be a woman for all I know. I just don't know. Yeah, I'm ready to race. What about how I beat? 22-9. Easy. Alright, other guy whose name I completely forgotten. You're going down.
Red Ross,
you're going down. I feel like I should do the customary, this is pod racing. There.
Now this is pod racing.
It seems like very dangerous to have obstacles on the road. You're just asking. Ow, I hit one.
Yeah, I noticed.
Scratch the paint mug. Oh, not like the bike. Ha! Paint mug damages. Man, it's good job that you're playing with type base to break at the end. I love animation.
Not again.
I love animation that is when you win. Arms in the air that you just don't care.
And he says exactly the same thing again.
This is a deja vu and just not progressing anywhere. Do I now get my prize money? What? There was no prize money. This day just keeps getting better and better. I would go drown my sorrows in the cantina, but I can't afford to. Yeah! Look at that bow. Woo!
I stabbed myself in the back while I was doing it, but oh well.
Right. Medkit, I'll be fine. Right now, win, Bastila, so she can clean cars on the. So I am that depraved.
People, hear me! Before I present the so-called champion of the Bex with their prize, there is something you must know. The winning rider cheated.
Bite
me.
You damn liar.
It's like, cheated. No, I'm just better than you.
Because of this hidden Beck treachery, I'm with.
See, if you want to win, you need to play the race card. That's how you win the arguments. Chunky Dora. I am not the Chunky Dora.
Chunky Dora.
Like a Dora the Explorer's personal chocolate bar. Chunky Dora, endorsed by Dora the Explorer. I am the wave of the future. Eat enough of these, you'll become a Chunky Dora. Sell this woman on the slave market myself.
Nobody can stop me. I might have something to say about that, Brezhik.
What? Impossible. You were restrained by a neural disruptor. How could you have possibly summoned the will to free yourself?
You underestimate the strength of a Jedi's mind, Brezhik. A mistake you won't live to regret.
Volkus, to me! Kill this woman!
Jedi
kill
code. Murder everyone you meet. Remember, Jedi don't kill. Uh-oh. Of course it ends in a massive fight, wouldn't it? Alright. I don't regret doing this. Wherever I go, someone wants to try and kill me.
Never ends well, does it?
Sucks to be me. Dead.
I wanted a simple life.
I wanted to be a swoop racer. Get famous. Yeah. Across the galaxy. You know, everywhere I go, Doran fans want to nab whatever you sign in Star Wars Universe. I doubt it's paper. Sign that astro droid. That sounds even dirtier. That's like a euphemism or something. Want me to sign your astro droid?
No, I don't sign protocol droids. That's different.
They're racist. On the program, I'm really racist. I just hate everyone.
To be fair, vertical droids are incredibly snooty a lot of the time. C-3PO certainly is.
C-3PO is in denial. It's like when they announced they were the gay characters in Star Wars. The internet's first response was, we all know C-3PO is gay. Oh, when the gay starts thing in Star Wars? Yeah, you're late by about 10 years.
How so?
Well, Juhani in this is gay, later or lesbian you meet later, play a female character, she's gay. And there are other Italian universal gay characters. It's not a new thing.
No.
It's just
doing the names.
It's just nowadays it's entirely marketable. Also, I threw a grenade and that guy blew up.
Bloody
Vulcus. Fuck
think
yeah.
Twice next time before trying to keep a Jedi.
Whoa, that's the language. This is a kid lash. I don't know what this is.
She's British.
Wait a minute, that means she's the enemy!
She's a Sith!
Take her down! I'm the Tenth Imperial, doesn't mean you're Sith, it means you're Imperial.
You mean you're Imperial, you're correct.
Do you like my visor? It makes me look badass. By riding in that swoop race? Well, as far as rescues go, this is a pretty poor... Oh, yeah. You'll get this now from this attitude. I free myself from that neural restraint collar
without your help. In fact, it's more accurate to say that I say...
Fine, I'll leave you to it. Toodles!
...and would have left you for dead if I hadn't stepped into that fight. You're lucky I was here to get you out of this mess.
Even the prisoners don't appreciate me.
But a Jedi is never helpless. Maybe you've heard of a little thing called the Force? But I suppose I shouldn't be too hard on you.
Never heard of it.
You did try to save me.
I prefer the plot device.
So let's get down to business.
Ah, the MacGuffin.
I'm
going to figure out a way for us to get off this planet. I need to know what kind of resources we can draw on. First, are we the only two survivors left from the Ender Spire?
Yes.
Karth and Nassi is alive.
Does he count?
Some good news. Karth is one of the
Republic's best soldiers. Him better than me.
He's proved himself a hero a dozen times over.
Why am I not a war hero?
Of course he is.
Maybe I misjudged you. Karth wouldn't have sent you if he wasn't confident in your...
Or misjudged Karth. It's either way.
Despite my Jedi training, I still tend to act a bit rashly sometimes.
Stuck up would be my...
Clearly I hadn't noticed.
Between the three of us, I'm sure we can figure out some way to get off this planet before the Sith realize we're here.
Oh, by three of us, I mean two of us. Because only two of us are important. And by the way, here's my laundry.
This is the flashback of how she left. Escape.
Flashback of what was going on sometime before when she faced Revan and killed him. Well, technically, Malik shot the ship and killed him. It's Darth Revan from the behind. Boom! Oh, that flourish. Hey, that ship did the job for me.
There's the mask.
Very low res mask.
Yeah, very low res.
Oh, she's dead. Oops.
Bastila, you're
alive. I didn't kill him. Jedi don't
things
kill.
Are looking up. Now I just need to find a way to get off somewhere. This planet.
You mean you don't have a plan to get off Taris yet? What have you been doing all this time?
Well, he's been playing with himself. I've been knee-deep in shit.
Perhaps we can start doing things properly. Hopefully our escape from Taris will go more smoothly than when you rescued me from Brezhik.
I know you're new at this,
you know,
Bastila,
at least it's
the
personality. Even if you want to punch her in the face.
Don't let your ego get in the way of the real issues here.
That hardly strikes me as an appropriate way of addressing your commander, Karth. I am a member of the Jedi Order, and this is my mission. Don't forget that. My battle meditation...
Run, technically part of the army! You won't get ruined.
And it will serve us well here, I'm sure.
Jedi don't fight in wars. Hence why the Mandalorian War whole thing happened.
A good leader would at least listen to the advice of those who have seen more combat than she ever will.
Yes.
Okay.
I side with it. Neither. I'm on my own side.
Of course, I'm happy to listen to your
I punch both of them in the face.
Stop the fighting,
first
please!
Off, we can't get hung
run
up on
mission. Mom and Dad are
we
fighting again.
To work together if we want to get off this rock. The answer is
I'll
there.
Just
we
kiss
just
you
have
two.
To find
and the sooner get over and done with.
Better. I've already been a prisoner of the Volkers, and I don't plan on being captured by the Sith.
Their rating on my hotel is dreadful for like accommodation.
Some help
too much
to
torture, not enough.
Maybe if we ask
room service,
the locals can help us out. We should probably start by asking around in the
cantina. They might just have a starship we can borrow.
Is something wrong? You seem as
woo, cantinas! Your attitude, ego, your hairstyle, and your outfit.
This is
I'm pretty sure those aren't official Jedi robes.
Such visions are often a sign of Force sensitivity.
Ooh, I'm a Jedi. Can I get into snooty attitude now?
You have some connection to the Force. It would not be unheard of. When we first met, your natural talent may have fed off my own Force abilities. It is possible that in the excitement of the battle's aftermath,
back
Force
to you again.
To witness one of my more intense memories.
That time where I actually tipped the waiter at that restaurant, he didn't deserve that tip.
With all my training, cannot fully understand it yet.
That Gungan was a
Some
dreadful waiter.
Left to the wise masters of the Jedi Council.
He up to me
when
my and then dropped all my stuff, fell over something in the
wax. Just a Jedi Knight.
Yeah, he's just a Jedi Knight. He just happens to have the power of battle meditation, which makes her incredibly important to everything.
Naturally.
So basically, she's trying to be captured by the Sith to use her abilities against the Republic and win the war.
Yes.
Because that's how that works.
Oh god, it's the end.
Yeah, next part we might actually get off Taris.
Oh, thank Christ.
So one colour for another colour.